Hello, and welcome to Thursday Thoughts. Today we are talking about, are you struggling with the end of summer? Labor Day will be upon us soon, signifying the end of summer. I become melancholic with the end of summer. Since Connor died, it is more difficult for me to face the changing in the seasons. Maybe it is because we both love summer. He would hang out with his friends at the skate park, back porch of a friend's house, hike, or be with his dog, Mac. I too love hiking and taking my dogs out. While we did not always do these things together, it is comforting knowing we enjoyed the same things. The biggie is that we share the love of sunrises. They're best enjoyed on a warm summer morning with his coffee and my tea. Most of that ends when the weather gets cold. I get sad when the green grass turns brown and tree leaves turn different colors. Do not get me wrong, I love the fall colors. Enjoy the cooler weather and the beauty of the trees turning exquisite reds, yellows, and oranges. I just had an aha moment while writing this. The change from outdoors to indoors is less opportunity for me to be grounded, literally staying grounded with my feet on the ground. Staying grounded is what keeps me going. If I'm struggling, all I need to do is go outside, look at the trees, and smell the fresh air. Standing outside in the warmth for just a mere 5 minutes resets me. Anything longer than that is a huge bonus. It fills up my energy tank. I grieve the end of summer. Coupled with the loss of my son, it holds even more significance. We've all heard about the seasons of life. The changing of the seasons of life cannot be stopped, no matter how hard you try. Maybe a little explanation will shed a bit of light on where you are in your season of life. Summer symbolizes that everything is perfect. It is exactly right. I am where I'm supposed to be. This is the times and memories with your loved ones. Fall takes away that feeling and brings harvest. With it may come some challenges that I do not want to face. It can take life to the inner core of finding oneself. We find ourselves wanting to make change, set new goals, and move forward. Winter is about the cold, lack of hope, and diminished energy. Acceptance of loss is difficult to do. Our grief may want to keep us in this season of winter. Spring is the purity of life. I have hope of the future. Here we realize that there is life after loss. Our loved one would not want us to be sad, but rather to go on living fulfilled life, even if it is without them. There are three things that will help in transition in the change and in the seasons. One is to accept it. I know this is difficult to do. To pretend the loss never happened keeps you in denial. You can only start healing once you have accepted the loss or the change of seasons. Two, take care of yourself. Exercise on a regular basis. I just got back from a walk. Eat healthy. I use powdered fruits and veggies to bridge the gap of what I eat and what I should eat. It is a shortcut to what I cannot do on my own. This is about supporting your immune system and keeping you healthy in a difficult time. Three, use grief as an opportunity to try something new. Meet a new neighbor, try a new sport, or make a long-lost dream come alive. Make the best of the seasons changing in your life. Understand your pain. Having suffered child loss myself, loss of a loved one, parent, child, or sibling is heart-wrenching and can feel hopelessness. It does not have to be that way. And I do want to let you know that I have a coaching program that helps you regain your life, preserve memories, and find joy. And if you are interested in meeting with me, that information will be at the end of this video. I hope that you can enjoy the rest of your summer days.